And on the last episode of the original fair.
You want to go out in the canoe?
On this episode of the original fair, I head to New Brunswick to get hands-on with Lobster.
This is crazy how much they have to like triple band it. You gotta double bag those beasts. So in
all the and have the best summer vacation ever. Join me as I attempt to hunt, forage, and farm my way across the globe in search of the world's best ingredients. I'm Kelly Cox, and this is The Original Fair. What do you think about the Red Rover Summer Cider?
Oh, it's a very good cider.
Yeah? Is it sweet? Because I do not care for that. I will lose it. What do you like beer-wise?
I really like the stout. I'm a dark beer drinker.
Oh, you're a dark beer drinker. Let's give it a go. Yeah, the lentil and potato tacos I was looking at and the chowder, I just feel like you kind of have to have that. I hear you guys use this homemade hot sauce in this.
We have Thai chilies in that. Make our Thai chili hot sauce here for our oysters.
Mmm. I love Thai chili hot sauce. Oh. Okay. All right. I'm good with this. Mmm. I'm pretty happy with just sitting on the coast in an old abandoned remodeled church. I'm okay with this. Well, I feel like I should just do the lobster roll because it's my first in New Brunswick.
Okay.
And I have a feeling it's probably the best, right?
Yeah.
Done. Thank you. Beautiful.
Enjoy.
Can I talk with my mouth full? Nobody minds, right?
We should try.
The key is the bread is perfect. We came here without a plan. Day one on the ground, roll up to Alma Lobster Shop. The woman who owns it, her two sons are both lobster fishermen. So they're gonna take us out on their boat tomorrow. And we're gonna do a 12-hour day at sea, working, capturing, harvesting lobsters, processing them, whatever that means. Started the lobster adventure in New Brunswick.
Migrate in the summer, lobsters migrate in as well. It's just like clockwork. Everything migrates.
Is that ours right there? Skippers or Tommy's or what? No, that's ours.
Short one?
Probably. I was gonna say, yeah, what's the size?
We got a gauge here.
So you tossed in new bait and it's going back in. One, two,
three.
Three in, spike it.
Toss it. That's it. That's fishing, that's everything. It's all you need to know. We haul this way for a bit and then like in an hour or so the tide turns, it starts running out, then you gotta haul up. You always haul against the tide.
So
then you put it behind his eye socket, like right there.
Right there.
First, then you pull back till it gets tight a little bit. Yep. Then that one's a keeper.
Okay. And then you go.
Yeah.
Bye, bud.
See this? That's a lobster with eggs.
That's a
pregnant female. There's nothing moodier and meaner than a pregnant female lobster. This one here, if you leave in the trap, will kill everything.
No.
Yep.
How old do you think this is?
It takes 7 years for the first pound.
Seven?
No, seven for the first pound.
So this is like what, 20 pounds?
60
years old?
Oh. And then half. I'm gonna say about 20, 25.
Oh, he's older than that. Look at it, like his claw, like his stings are all marked. That's crazy. You're a vet, old man. He's like, I'm done. I'm done with life anyways. I honestly think I like this better than crabbing.
Yeah.
Maybe this is my next career move.
The only time we keep full-time guys on the boat is when they do like the fall season or scallop fishing too.
Well, are there ever girls that get to do those jobs?
Never been out here in the fall. It's not like this.
We can't handle it, Joe?
No, I've worked with other girls before, very good workers. The physical part of it, the lugging, lifting, everything.
We can handle that. Do girls ever get to do this for summer work?
We've had them out scalloping before.
Feeling a little blocked in this industry. Not happy. Could you just easily get a lobster permit? If you wanted to get in on this
game? Anybody can get one, you gotta buy one.
How much?
For the one we're fishing, a couple million, like two.
Okay.
You could buy maybe one for like $2.5 million right now.
Are you fucking kidding? But did your grandfather start this?
Grampy bought his lobster license for 25 cents.
For 25 cents? And then can you just generation it down or do you have to buy it?
No, you can pass it down.
You can pass it down, right?
Yep.
Grew up in the wrong place, in the wrong family. In Missouri.
The next day in Alma, the owners of the Parkland Village Inn take me out for a little lobster on the beach.
Yeah. That one's good. Okay, let's see if I can remember. Okay.
This one's
Oh yeah. Boom.
Ready?
What?
Oh, wait, are we doing a hand motion too? Like this? Okay. All right, ready? One, two, three. Let's get started! I've never cooked
lobster before. It's one of the easiest things to cook.
I mean, it's basically crab, right?
You just drop it in the water, and then you take it out of the water.
Wait, I need to get a notepad. And do you typically just
cook on the beach?
Yeah, never.
A couple times.
In
couple
your life.
Times. A couple times.
Never. Never. And we're all twins, by the way.
Yeah.
Did we notice our twins moment?
Fundy National Park sweaters.
Triplets. Boom.
Boom. All right, ready? You can get the last one.
Yep.
There you go.
Is there any way for you to visually know if it's done or not?
No, not really. It's a timing thing. How cold is the bay?
We're just putting our feet in, Mark. That's it. I'm not. Come on, gals.
We should crack lobsters first because they're ready.
Are they ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
17 seconds.
Let's do it. What do you mean
crack it? As per the New Brunswick lobster cooking guidelines.
What is that?
11 minutes a pound.
And these are all about 1 pound, huh?
These are all a pound.
Well, all right, cool,
you ready to get cracking? Let's try one. You crack this one right here. This is
exactly what you should do after a million beers. Okay, so I forget, what am I making? Where am I?
Like this, ready? And then snap the claws off.
All right,
like dislocate them, pull them back.
Just like you would a chicken.
Just like a man's arm. Or your ex-boyfriend's that. Arm. Just like your ex-boyfriend's arm. All right, now take it and twist.
Like this.
Yeah.
Like poke. That?
Yeah. Boom. Boom. There you go.
Okay. And we're going.
Push all the way down. There you go now, bring it down. All right, now, the Alma way to crack a lobster.
This is what I want to know. This is what I want to see.
This is the messy, fun way.
This is the fun way.
The messy, fun way. You got it.
I will say my fingernails and my fingers are quite handy. And teeth.
Good piece of
pickaroon. Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah.
And see, then there's no better way to eat lobster than sitting on the beach.
Mm-hmm.
Just
so
using your hands, good people around you.
That's perfect.
It's like we just pulled them out of the ocean.
Oh, it's perfect.
Pulled them out of the ocean.
Amazing. Look at that moon! Moon!
I got it. Here.
La Luna.
La Luna! I love you, La Luna. Ow, ow, ow!
I've already had it.
We should be, it's all we should be doing. Drinking beers, releasing some baby lobsters into the water.
Yeah, nothing stressful about what we're doing. What we do at Homeris is raising lobsters to a certain point to put lobster back in the ocean, make sure it's there, it's healthy. The lobster industry in New Brunswick is huge.
It's huge.
Yeah.
So there's an economic, because you know, I've seen the fishermen, I've seen signs for lobster everywhere, I've eaten a lot of lobster.
Yeah.
I guess it's pretty important to preserve this as part of the economic structure.
Right, right. It's an economic pillar. Exactly.
Yeah.
All along the coast, it's just small, not fishermen villages, but it's
lobster villages.
It's
right?
Lobster villages, yeah.
We are here.
We have arrived. The baby lobsters have a home.
Found out that about 40 to 50% of what we release will survive. It's as small as a dime, but at a point where they will go straight to the bottom, find hiding, and basically survive way more than you would find in the natural cycle.
We are in Shediac, which is at the base of the Acadian coast in New Brunswick. We just so happen to be here during Lobster Festival. There is a massively long table going down the center of town where they're doing like the longest lobster supper. So, I mean, I never knew a culture got so jazzed about their local fish before, but you learn something new on Original Fare every day, so here we go.
Alors, on aimerait remercier à tous ceux et celles qui sont ici aujourd'hui. Thanks for you all for being here today for that biggest long table for supper.
So, how long has the Lobster Festival been going on?
68 years.
No. Has it changed a lot over time?
Become bigger.
It's gotten bigger. Do you guys mind a lot of people coming in and celebrating it? You know, it's fine. Oh, I'm so excited. Merci beaucoup. Oh yeah, this is cold. I learned the beer trick, but I don't have a bottle. Mm-hmm. You gotta really get into it. Now we got it. Crack it a few times. Oh!
I got it.
It's really interesting to me that you get lobster here and you eat it with nothing else. But at any place that doesn't actually get lobster, it's all the other stuff with it. Butter and lemon and ketchup, mayo. I love ketchup, but who would put that on a lobster?
These guys have just as much ability to go as far as the guys, trust me.
That is facing my fear from my childhood. Right there, on this zipper. Proudly brewed in the Maritimes.
Yeah, St. John, New Brunswick.
All right, I'm going for this one.
St. John, New Brunswick, right here. Live and loud.
We're gonna go pick some of these?
Some of these Hascap berries.
Hascap.
Yeah.
Hascap, because I always want to say Hacksap.
Yeah, Hacksap.
Are these actually native to the area, or did you guys genetically modify these in your basement?
We genetically modified them, ordered GMO seeds.
Mm-hmm.
Shh.
Is your dad gonna come yell at us?
Yeah. So look at these ones here. Like,
yeah, those look good.
Yes. Like, we've been farming this plot of land here for like 10 years, and I've never seen an actual profit. And I buy off myself and put it back into one of my other businesses.
Yeah.
So it's like one of those things that it's a lot of hard work. There's a lot of like infrastructure you got to set up.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of like farming is, it's a lifestyle. It's not a get rich quick scheme.
I give chefs a hard time because for me, I always like to put the emphasis back on the farmer or the fisher or who's getting the ingredient. Whereas the flip side is, number one, restaurants aren't
the most profitable businesses. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a very hard industry, but you are balancing both realms.
I'm insane.
These look good.
Yeah, these ones look like they're ready to go. Ooh, beets.
Beets.
Some beet downs.
Get a little beet down.
Oh, these are all borage flowers too.
Those look good. Ooh, I like those.
Mm-hmm. Cut a few of these off.
Those are fun.
Oh, definitely need some lovage. You ever have lovage?
No.
Okay, here.
Work for this business.
Take a little bit of that.
Oh, snap.
Bam, like big, yeah. Crazy, like celery.
Yeah, that's an intense flavor.
Yeah, a little bit of chives.
Always.
Always chives. Intense.
It smells good in here. Is it the nasturtiums?
Yeah.
Wow.
Eating pretty food.
It's gonna be real pretty.
It's gonna be like, you know, we'll bring the tweezers. Have all the tweezers.
Let's all get the tweezers out and we'll tweeze out the dish and then we'll just pluck each other's eyebrows.
Chest hair.
Whose chest is hairier? Let's find out on the next episode.
All right, I think we got some stuff.
I think this looks good.
Yeah.
We got color.
We got all the color.
We got all the color.
Bam, bam.
Take that. That's a cowboy cauldron.
There we go. And we'll just build the fire around that.
Well done, guys.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, ooh, cauldron. Cauldron light.
Cheers, guys. Now we got superpowers.
Oh,
thank you for service.
Yeah, just right there. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so drop them in. Add there.
Thank you, lobster gods. Oh, he's mad. He's not going out without a fight. I love you. Thank you. I'm sorry.
I grabbed some ribs from the barbecue, smoking pig. Too, just to throw on there so we get some extra snacks.
That kind of looks like a witch's food.
Yeah, it's like the witch's brew.
The witches of the woods brew.
Yeah, you got her.
There we go. Woo, that one's hot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That should be all of them.
That should be all of them right there. Now we're gonna go for the clams here.
Well, I don't know. I saw the way Jesse does it,
yeah. We get a lot of clams here.
Let me do this. So just tear the sides and then tie it up. Bibs coming.
Yay, Bibs.
Bibs coming. Wait, where's your hot sauce at?
Oh, it's back here.
What?
The forks are here. Would you guys like a little fork?
Yeah, I'm going to thrust that in there right now.
That dinosaur kale and those clams.
Yummy.
Did you get a big claw with a barnacle? That's cool.
Yep. Shane, you want me to make it?
And on the last episode of the original fair.
There's paddles. Life jackets. Yeah, we should have life jackets.
Yeah, turn the headlamp off. You're giving me a headache.
I can't see anything. Where are we going?
That way.
Hi,
I got it.
Hey, towards the
spoons.
For more adventures in food, subscribe to our channel.